I think this was very life-changing for the students. The vast majority of our choir has never traveled outside of the United States, and many have never traveled in an airplane before. So this was a totally eye-opening experience for a lot of people, both culturally, also as a coming together time. I think that people are never the same once they experience something like this with other people. I think that the students on this trip they know each other on a different level now, and I think that they will remain close after this type of experience.
I think all travel is life experience, changes your life experience. Every time you go out of the country, there is something more to learn, something more to see, something more to experience. All of it is life-changing because it's a building block. And for the students to have that kind of an experience is something that is really unique and can only benefit the maturity and growth of young people. I can't imagine making a better investment than to make it in the international tour that West Liberty continues to make.
And change anything, I don't think I would. You know, I think that KI Concerts, the company that we use, is a wonderful company. They plan things brilliantly. Everything is well balanced, and I just think that everything really worked together harmoniously, and I wouldn't change a thing, really. It was a wonderful experience.
so excited.
I am excited.
I'm really excited, but I think I'm going to be even more so when I get off the plane in Dublin.
I mean, I had a couple of nightmares that, like, I, like, got lost in Ireland or, like the plane crashed. But, like, I'm okay now. I feel like all my fears just, like, went out. But, yeah, so I'm just excited now.
This trip benefited the students because they, first of all, they had an opportunity to be able to experience different cultures, sing in different places, sing in some really famous places, meet people of another country, get to sing with students of another country, learn about their culture, learn about their music education. Obviously, they got to sing in some pretty amazing spaces like Christchurch Cathedral in Dublin. The cathedrals in Killarney and Galway are just, you know, wonderful old stone structures that you just don't get a chance to sing in this country. So that was really wonderful. Just the experience of being able to sing with an orchestra in another country is huge. The experience of traveling, of learning about other people's cultures, of learning about how other people live their daily lives, and just expanding their horizons, all those things were really important. This is one of the great things that we're able to offer at West Liberty, is the chance for students to be able to go outside of their comfort zone, outside of the thing that they know, and learn about other people, the way that other people do things in other parts of the world, make music on a very high level, and let other people in other cultures experience what they do. I think it was very powerful for me, and I'm positive that it was powerful for our students.
Going on international tours is just an amazing experience for everyone. And beyond the obvious benefits that it gives our students, you know, the education is unparalleled, right? And that's an obvious benefit. The second obvious benefit is that people get out of their norm and they get to see another whole culture. And that's really exciting. And dealing with things on the fly, you know, like lost passports and things like that, It's a wonderful education, right? The tangible benefits are amazing, but as a student of history, it must be just amazing to walk the fields that you learned about in high school and that maybe you're learning about in your history class, and you say, oh yeah, I remember learning about the potato famine, you know, as most of our kids did say, when our guide would tell us a lot of historical facts or geological facts. That was really an exciting moment that the guide was able to really educate us, and we learned so much. I mean, singing was wonderful in these beautiful cathedrals, but there was a lot of education. It was wonderful.
I think it was an amazing awakening. I think that broadening their experiences was a tremendous benefit. Developing a sense of community. Being with 40 people for 1 week is quite a demand, and I think the students learned a lot about Ireland, learned a lot about each other, and certainly learned about themselves.
Okay, so Galway Cathedral is a brand new cathedral as far as cathedrals go. It was established, I believe, in the 60s, in the 1960s. So in cathedral years, it's just an infant. The cathedral itself was very, very large. It was the largest cathedral that we did sing in. It was very open, and there was not a soft surface in the entire building. It was just all hard surface. The organ itself was very far away. The organ was all the way back, probably 100, almost 100 yards, maybe even away from the front, from the altar. So also the organ was facing the opposite direction. So the organist had to look in this little tiny mirror, just about this big, and try to see me a football field away. And John is an amazing organist, so he was able to do it about as good as I think anybody could do it. But the actual acoustic environment was really wonderful, and it was really especially wonderful for the unaccompanied singing. It was a very live space. Things rung for seconds after you would cut the cord off. So Galway Cathedral, I think, was probably the best for just choral music, just the plain choral stuff. And it was also good with the orchestra. The one challenge that we had was the organ being so far away, but we were able to meet that challenge pretty well. That was also the first concert we did, so everybody was a little bit more nervous than perhaps usual. But it still was a very, very strong concert, and it had that new energy to it for a first performance.
Thank you.
St. Mary's perhaps was one of the most beautifully, just the visually beautiful image. Some of the images that have been floating around in Facebook and things like that of that purple backdrop, that mood lighting up in front, that's of St. Mary's Cathedral in Killarney. Very, very beautiful space. Acoustically, the least live of the three that we sang in, but as far as performing with an orchestra, it was easier to do this stuff with the orchestra because you could hear more of the articulation and you could hear more of the rhythmic elements of it. It wasn't as hard to put that together. The organ was still in the back, but it was not as far away, and it was sort of angled so that the organist could kind of see over his shoulder if he looked that way. So it was a little easier as far as the organ, but it was also the smallest organ that we were dealing with, so the organ itself wasn't able to provide as much power as it was in Galway, which was a massive organ in Galway. But still a very nice instrument. So the Killarney Cathedral was, I would say, maybe the most emotional concert we did as far as the entire concert goes, just because of the tragedy that happened that day. And just, it was a very beautiful space.
I think it went really well. Everyone did a fantastic job, and they all brought their A game, and we just, for lack of a better phrase, tore the house down with it.
This concert probably was not the best concert. The last concert was amazing, and Lindsay, her solo was my favorite part of this. I don't know, I had a lot of emotion wrapped up in this one. It was nice.
Each year, it's just totally amazing to us what these students can do. Performance-wise and getting together, being attentive, being grateful, was just amazing to me. Students who go on this trip are really special students. Not only are they talented in their own right, but in combining the forces, it makes it an exceptional performance. And the people of Ireland were very warm and welcoming, but incredibly grateful to be hearing a quality choir in their hometowns. The trips to Galway, Killarney, and Dublin were incredibly enriching. And the benefits were innumerable, and the students had a fabulous time. They were responsible, they were committed, they were mannerly, and I was very, very pleased to see all of that happening with them.
The most interesting thing, in my opinion, is something that is the whole reason why I go on these tours. And that's to see students, especially those who have never gone anywhere or even flown in a plane before, to see the eyes open, to see the reality of their world expand at the time. That's just an amazing part that I can play in someone's life, is to be there when they get it. You know, they have that aha moment where they realize something, or there's a massive connection to the earth and to people in general. And to be part of someone's life when they have a life-altering moment is that moment for me. And I love when that happens.
Oh my, the most interesting thing to happen to us on the trip. You know what? Actually, the trip was pretty smooth, I have to say. There wasn't any one big moment that was a big disaster or a big thing that we had to endure. I would say the most difficult day was probably the day that tragedy in Killarney happened, and we had to figure out how we were going to do the concert, or if we were even going to do the concert there that day. We had to rearrange our rehearsal schedules. We had to be sensitive to the needs of the people there, because there was a tragedy that occurred there, and it was more important than what we were doing. But ultimately, we were able to make that tragedy turn into something that was really positive, because the few people that did come to that concert in Killarney were people that you could tell were impacted by that tragedy that occurred. And our performance was really stellar that night because I think we were channeling into something that was a little bit greater than us. So I think that was a really powerful experience. I know it was a powerful experience for me. I think it was a powerful experience for our students as well. On a more humorous side, some of the interesting things that occurred to us was, let's see, Brady left his tux in the first hotel that we stayed in, so we had to get that like FedExed over to the new place in time. Brody got locked in the bus bathroom for a whole like probably 20 minutes, which was kind of humorous. Everybody got off the bus and he was stuck in the bathroom. We didn't realize he was there until we got back. That was a funny thing that happened to us. But you know, other than that, I think it was pretty smooth, and anything that happened was minor and we sort of were able to laugh it off.
Dr. Glisson and Lynn and Ben Exley and I, we sit down, we try to pre-think these kinds of situations out. What if situations, right? When you have maybe a lost passport or maybe a lost tuxedo or something like that, both of which almost happened. But you know, you try to think these things through. So luckily, I think we did a really good job of kind of presupposing, right? What the problems could be or could have been, and then reacting in such a way or having a plan to deal with things. So I don't think anything was unexpected, I wouldn't say. I mean, I said to many people when we came back, even some of the problems were just fine.
We went into a couple really sketchy bathrooms. We went to one like the bottom of the flower shop and we thought we were gonna get killed.
I didn't have any scary experiences until on the way back home when I almost got arrested in the airport, because for future reference, pepper spray is illegal in that country. It's the same charge as trying to bring in a firearm.
To be the Cliffs of Moher, and I would be surprised if that wasn't everybody's favorite. I don't know, but the cliffs are just—it's just that natural beauty, you know. And we were there at the perfect time of day. It was sunny, but it wasn't too sunny. So we have awesome pictures. I've seen a lot of pictures on Facebook, and everybody got wonderful shots. And you could really enjoy the countryside because it wasn't raining. You could really walk up and down, and it was just really awesome to be in the presence of that kind of natural beauty. You don't often always see that. And it does, I think, make you appreciate what you have at home as well. And maybe when we come home, we can remember how beautiful it was, and we can turn that gaze to look at some of our own West Virginia natural beauty as well, and realize that, you know what, there's some beautiful things around here, and maybe we need to open our eyes a little bit more and really see it.
I was most excited about coming here to the Cliffs of Moher, and it's just breathtaking. It's my first view of the ocean, so it's really neat.
definitely, these are the most beautiful thing. I mean, I've never seen anything like this in my life. It's a great opportunity to be here. I've been talking to Gabby saying I wouldn't mind moving here, or at least visiting again. It's incredible.
It's really awe-inspiring to see something so big and like humongous. It makes you feel very small, but it's like comforting almost.
So amazing. And I'm not gonna lie, my favorite part might be that they're in Harry Potter. I'm a huge Harry Potter fan, but just the sight of them is awe-striking. Beautiful.
The most interesting thing that happened over there was probably watching the students go to the moors and watching their faces and letting them climb those moors was very spectacular. Of course, that's only secondary to watching them perform, because that really was the highlight.
Defining moments for the choir. I would say, you know, our choir, we spend a lot of time singing together, and we've spent a lot of time singing together before this trip. So we're a pretty solid group. We're pretty ready for anything. The choir is around me enough that they know. I think they can tell when I think things are going well and when I think things aren't. So their energy kind of goes with that, and the choir tends to pick me up sometimes. I will tell you, during the rehearsal, the first rehearsal that we did, I was not feeling well. When we landed in Dublin, I had some sort of stomach bug or something, because on the trip over to Galway, I was really struggling. It was tough. In the second day, we had a 3-hour rehearsal in the morning. It was our only rehearsal with the orchestra. And I was just really, I was like having to sit on a stool because I was not feeling very well at all. The choir really stepped up, and I just was not able to provide a lot of energy in that rehearsal, to be honest. But the choir stepped up, and they lifted me up, which was a really special thing for me, to be able to know that I could rely on my singers, and that I don't, you know, they helped me that time, where sometimes it's the other way around. I feel like they really helped me.
You know, what I love most about this experience is that when other people that are not connected with our kids and are not connected with West Liberty observe our kids and Dr. Glisson in action, you know, there's a moment that they get it, you know, and they say, wow, these people. I don't think that the audiences in Ireland were particularly different. I will tell you this, I did miss our parents and our family members. You know, I wish everyone could come the next time, because you do miss that wonderful energy that our parents and our family gives us, and our friends and colleagues. You know, I did miss that. But as audiences go, I didn't feel that there were any differences.
Finally, the Christchurch Cathedral. Christchurch Cathedral, I mean, it was the best way to end the concert. It had the best of everything. So Galway probably had the best just pure choral music, because it was the most live space. St. Mary's probably had the best for articulation, because it was the driest space. Christchurch was somewhere in between. It was good for everybody. So Christchurch was a nice balance of really resonant space, beautiful, beautiful, stunning space. Christchurch Cathedral also dates back to the 11th century, which is something that, you know, when you sing in a space that's that old and has that feel to it, that's a whole different thing. It was a more intimate space, not as big as Galway Cathedral, so it felt more, we felt like closer to the audience. The organ was actually in front of us this time, so we were actually able to see him, and that made things a lot easier, because he was able to be with us the entire time.
concerts were incredibly successful. The experience of singing in a beautiful space, you know, and we in Wheeling, we do have our beautiful spaces, but over there, historically, huge cathedrals, beautiful organs, and just the singing in something that you know is 1,000 years old. It's just there's just a little bit extra there, right, that isn't there when you're singing in Wheeling or Wellsburg or Morgantown even. So it's an amazing thing. I think that was really brilliant. The concerts themselves went so well, and especially the last concert. The last concert is always a touching moment for everyone, because not only is it the last concert, sometimes it is literally, you know, the last concert for some of our seniors. For some people who may know that they're going to go into their own major and not have a chance to participate in choir anymore, although we don't want that to happen, sometimes it does. And to just know that this might be the last time you get to do something like this, that brings out a lot of emotion. It was very touching.
Super emotional concert. By the end of it, I think I honestly have never conducted a choir where I've looked and like almost half the people in the choir are weeping, crying before the concert's even over. Because just the powerful experience that the trip was, the emotional connection that we had with the music, it was really special. You could just tell that people were connecting to the music in such a deep way. I kept having to sort of do this a lot of times because everybody was really singing with as much as they possibly could because they were so energized. If anything, it was sometimes a little loud. I had to keep people down. But so much energy, so much passion, so much enthusiasm was really inspiring. I don't know if I have a favorite part, but if I had to pick a favorite part, I probably would have to pick the Christchurch Cathedral concert. It was the end of the trip. It was a very emotional experience for the entire group. The instrumentalists and the choir were finally really locked in together. The space was beautiful. I very much enjoyed the places that we ate, and specifically the final night. That was a really wonderful space too. The final night when we all got together at the end after the concert, which was a really emotional experience, we were taken to this restaurant that was kind of like sort of built into the ground almost. We went down in there, there was the candlelight, and we were all in a private sort of room where we were able to talk, and we started singing at one point. We sang through some ridiculous piece, you know, Coconut Nut or something like that. We sang through this thing. And it was just a great environment. People were just standing up and toasting each other, and everybody had nice things to say about everybody. And it was a great way to end the trip. I am very happy. We had a wonderful trip. It was a great time. I would do it again in a heartbeat. I'm very happy that I'm not dealing with people's money anymore. I am so thankful to not have that price tag hanging over my head anymore. Now, that being said, it was overwhelming. The generosity of people is overwhelming. I think we have created friendships and partnerships that are going to last for years to come. So much good has come out of that. And also, I would like to say a thank you to the students too, because the students who participated in this were not, you know, they gave of themselves, both monetarily and time-wise. And it was a total effort, all of us, from myself to our students, to Dr. Cowan, to the university, to our donors, our fantastic donors. Everybody gave something to make this happen. And so for that, we are all eternally grateful.
I was very almost overjoyed to see the relationship that all of these folks had for each other. A lot of that has to do with the fact that Dr. Glisson worked night and day in preparation for this trip, and that's always a big factor.
Our kids are just the greatest kids ever. I can't say enough about our kids, and I know say kids, young adults, but they're so wonderful. They're so well behaved. They're so respectful. They're so funny, and they take everything in stride, and they're not high maintenance. And I think that that's always really shocking and surprising to people, like, oh, this is going to be a college group, right? We're going to have some difficulties. No, we don't. You know, we just have great people, great people.
It all came to Dr. Glisson in his relationship with his students. You could tell when they were performing that there was something, there was a synergy there that is really remarkable. And I just want to express my and Ben's appreciation for coming on this trip and watching that, because it was really remarkable. Absolutely remarkable.
I don't know if I would do anything different, to be honest. I think I'd keep it exactly the same.
And anything else you'd like to add?
I think that's about it.